So today's topic is heat exchangers and heat interchangers. As we have seen in conduction, convection and all, there will be transfer of heat from one region to other region, or from the hotter region to the cooler region, or from the hotter fluid to the cooler fluid. So heat exchangers are heat interchangers. Basically, they are the equipments or the instruments which are used for heating a particular fluid with the help of the steam or with the help of the steam or with the help of the heat. So heat exchangers are nothing but used for transfer of heat from one fluid to another fluid through the metal wall. And heat interchangers are nothing but transferring of heat from one liquid to another liquid or from one gas to another gas through the metal wall is called heat interchangers. Now, what are the heat exchangers and heat interchangers? We'll be seeing in detail with the help of the equipments. Through the equipment, we'll be seeing the concept of heat exchangers and heat interchangers. Heat exchangers, they are of three types, that is tubular heater, multiple pass heater, two pass floating heater. Okay. Three types are there. First is tubular heater, second is multiple pass heater, and third is two pass floating head heater. Tubular head heater is also known as single shell or single pass heater. Okay, you can write single pass heater also. Now we will see one by one. First is tubular heater or single shell tube heater. It's a simple form of the heater and it's also known as single pass tubular heater. Okay. Now construction. The construction of this tubular heater is somewhat like this. Understand the diagram properly, because all the heaters will have similar diagrams and slight difference will be there. So don't get confused in the diagram. The tubular heaters will be looking like this. A cylindrical shell or cylindrical chamber is present, and this is a cylindrical chamber or a shell, and it's having many tubes placed in it in a vertical position, and you can see many inlets and many outlets present surrounding the cylindrical shell. Okay, so one by one details we'll be seeing. The cylindrical shell is there, and D1 and D2, they are the distribution chamber. Matlab here the distribution or the flowing of liquids or your fluids, it will be done here in the chambers. These are the tubes present in the chamber, and this one is a steam inlet, F, given by the letter alphabet F, steam inlet. It's a vent. Next one is a vent, that is K. This vent is used for passing away the non-condensed vapors. Okay, and this D1 is a distribution chamber. It's a side cover. This one. And condensate outlet is given as G here, and it is used for passing away the condensed vapor, and vent is used for passing away the non-condensed vapor. Now C is a casing tubes, or tubes are present here, and I inlet is given as H here, that is inlet for cool fluid. Now we have one inlet and one outlet for steam, and other inlet and outlet for fluid. This is the inlet for steam, and it is the outlet for steam, that is condensed outlet. And for the non-condensed vapor, it is given as K. Yoga steam ka. For fluid, H.